sit inside the shelters, coordinate with air traffic control, provide surveillance and reconnaissance for ground troops, pretty much anyone who needs us.
When it comes to the mission, and you're inside operating, you actually have to be extremely focused. It's unlike manned aviation where it's very tactile. You have to know if something is going wrong just based on instrumentation.
Before we can put an aircraft in the air, we have to do what's called preventive daily maintenance. So PMDs are done every day for every aircraft. And since troubleshooting is about 50% of the job, when it comes to problems, having competence with mechanics and electrical systems definitely is a plus.
1100, takeoff time, 1200.
So this is a great
land time 1800
situation military-wise, because everywhere else, you know, you're a sergeant down here or higher up, lieutenant or so forth. But here, we're all on the same level as far as making sure that the system works and it does what it's supposed to do.
Going through training to be an operator is very difficult in some aspects.
It's school. It's 8 hours a day. 4 hours of homework.
They combine years of schooling into very few months.
So when it comes to math and science, if you've pursued that or pushed that in your school system, once you move over to this system, then it's a very good transfer.
You can find a very well-paying job with this system. UAVs is going to be the future. Interfaces that we use here are completely usable in the outside world. It's civilians, General Dynamics, Raytheon, Northrop Grumman, Boeing, they all use UAVs. They all have those electronic systems.
It's definitely a field that's happening. It's moving. So the best thing to do is get in on the ground floor, get in the pipeline, and, you know, it's pretty exciting.